like you lost another one.
Rainmaker, and I mean, if you don't know who I am, just look around you. I mean, you can't look 10 feet from me and not see a poster of the excellence. So, anyways, episode 21 of the Rainmaker Saga. Today is gonna be just training. I'm gonna have like two training sessions today. So, I think I'm gonna be doing some MMA training this morning, followed by cardio, some abs, and then. I have jiu-jitsu class tonight, so it's going to be an action-packed day. So, typically in the morning, I wake up and take my kids to school, and then I like to sit. My morning ritual is typically sitting right here and just relaxing for a good 30 minutes to an hour. I like to just sit here, gather my thoughts, gather my chi. Also, you know, once my day gets started, it's nonstop moving. So I like to just sit here and gather my thoughts. Sometimes if my legs are really sore, I'll use those over there. That's like a compression. So some mornings I'll use those for my legs to get some recovery before I start my day. And then as you can see right now, you can show them the I got the TENS unit on my back. So I kind of strained my back a little bit yesterday at jiu-jitsu class. So right now I got this on here, and I don't know if you can see it, but it's got my muscles straight jumping. So, man, last video, episode number 20 of the Rainmaker Saga, I got like 39 views, but only 2 likes. So what's up, guys? If you're watching this, drop a like on the damn video. I'm never going to get any more views if y'all don't show some love. You know what I'm saying? YouTube just thinks I'm a little turd, apparently. Because y'all ain't liking the videos. So like the video. Share it. Share it on your Facebook, your Instagram, something like that. Help a brother out. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to get some clout up before I go pro. That'd be nice. So, I mean, like the video. If you're not subscribed already, please subscribe. And I'm trying to get to 1,000 subscribers. Right now, I'm only at 155. So, I got some ways to go. So, help a brother out. Subscribe to the channel. If you don't know how, just look around the screen. Look underneath the video. It's going to be a little button that says subscribe. Click that. Click the notification bell. So, when I upload a video, it'll send you a notification. Now, I'm not one of those channels that uploads every day. I don't even always upload every week. So, you know, hit the notification bell. You don't have to worry about notifications popping up on your phone all the time. It's going to be just a couple times a month, and you won't miss any of my videos. So, go ahead and do that. And important news. So, I got a fight coming up. It's 17 days away, October 29th, in Memphis, Tennessee. for Attitude MMA, and I'm fighting a guy named Salim, or Zoba Salim, something like that. He's like 5-0, so really tough opponent. It's gonna be a great fight. Like, I'm really excited for this. Yes, he's a wrestler, so y'all already know what I'm going to. I ain't even got to tell y'all. You know, y'all know what I'm going to. I got something for him. It's called a ones and a twos and a knees to your from the front all the way through. Okay. So yeah, I'm just gonna sit here, wait for my instructor to get here. I've been doing a lot of private lessons, so I mean my technique has really been like this. Most people, you know, they get better like this. But I've been getting better like this. Like a straight line up. So, you know, a lot of my strategies are how to beat their ass and not let them even, you know, get their hands around me. So, which I mean, that's of course what everybody wants to do. They want to beat somebody up without getting touched. But I'm actually good at that. That's my specialty. But anyways, yeah, 17 days out, I'm going to get this vlog done, try to do this vlog today, and then try to edit it as fast as I can. This is me editing, even though it's more actually like this. But I'm going to edit it as fast as I can, pump it out, and yeah, enjoy. Time for cardio. Just finished my private lesson. Obviously, I'm not gonna show y'all, you know what I'm saying, the secret recipe. I'll give you a little snippet of a punch, maybe a kick, but I'm not gonna, you know what I'm saying, I can't show you guys too much. But I'm gonna show y'all a little workout. You know, I do a lot of different workouts. I like doing circuits. Some days I'll jump rope for 30 minutes. Sometimes I use the light rope if I'm doing a long time. And then this babble right here, this is just draining. This will kill you right here. And sometimes I'll do both in one session, you know. So I love to jump rope. But right now I'm just gonna do a circuit. I'm gonna go arms for a minute, arms for a minute, legs for a minute, arms for a minute, legs for a minute. I'll do 5 minutes and then take a little break, and then I'll switch to, I'll pretty much do the same thing for 15 minutes, a total of 15 minutes. So, and then after that, I'll do abs. So. tons of exercise. You ask me what's my favorite, really I just love exercising in general. I love working on every muscle group. Everything from head to toe, neck, jaw, head, fingers, toes, everything. But I will say this, the one exercise I hate the most out of all exercises, this is my least favorite. Because it's like the best for cardio, the leg cardio. Fucking jumping lunges. And that may not be the case for some people. Like somebody with shorter legs, I got long ass legs. So dude, jumping lunges, hate them. Man, it's terrible.
To look at them while you're working on them too. Making sure everything is engaged. Don't just go through the motions. It's not about doing it fast, either the slower the better.
it's hard to build. All this is, but like definitely right here. Finished the private lesson this morning, finished my cardio, abs. So now I'm gonna give me a little something to eat. So I'll show y'all what I have for lunch. Well, actually, first I need to stretch. Can't slack on that.
How many Saturdays do you typically train if you're Monday through Friday is your normal?
If I got a fight coming up, I'm going to be training every Saturday.
Understandable.
Unless I train super hard during like blew my shit out. Like when I got a, if I got a fight coming up, I really have to earn a Saturday off. But typically, no, I'm going to, I mean, sometimes I'll actually go Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, take off Thursday, train Friday and Saturday, and take off Sunday. So I'll take off 2 days a week. Which you can do that if you're training twice, you know, twice a day, 5 days out of the week, you know. But it's all about feeling, waking, knowing how you feel. Like, I feel fucking great. There's no reason I can't push hard as fuck tonight, you know, at jiu-jitsu class. So, yeah, I feel good. But anyways, time for lunch. It's 11:55 now, so I stretch for like 25 minutes. All right, so before I have my lunch, so I haven't ate anything today. I woke up, drank some Kratom, and that's all I had. Drank some water, of course. And now I'm gonna have a little protein shake. So this is Vita Hustle One Superfood. It's a vegan protein powder. Dude, this shit's fire. Dark cacao. Look, I'm telling you. All right, this company is Kevin Hart's company. He need to go ahead and sponsor me, cause this shit's fire. I got a subscription for this, so it just comes to my house every month, and it's fire for real. No dairy, no gluten, no artificial sweeteners, no added sugar, no sugar alcohols, no soy, no GMO. So it's got 86 superfoods and nutrients, 20 grams of plant-based protein, 22 vitamins and minerals, MCT oil and omega-3, probiotics and prebiotics, clinically attested adaptogens, I don't even know what the hell that is, and digestive enzymes. So this shit's fine. I mean, this stuff is really, really good. This is a good quality super shake. So,
Kevin Hart had it.
Yep, this is Kevin Hart's shit. You know Kevin Hart's a G, so. Two scoops of this. Man, and it tastes like, you know when you're making chocolate fucking brownies and you taste that batter? This is what it tastes like. It's fire, for real. I never had no protein shake that tastes good. But it's not really a protein, it's not a protein shake. It's a superfood shake. So it's not like some shit you want to take to bulk up or whatever. Which I mean, I'm sure you could, but this is more about getting in a lot of nutrients and vitamins and minerals. It's about nutrients. So I'm gonna drink this before I have lunch. I'm gonna drink this, take a shower, and then get my lunch.
Except it didn't get all over the kitchen, it got all over me.
That's fire. Oh, also, so a package just showed up for me. Powerful Fitness package. Perfect timing for the vlog. So this is, I'm working on creating a workout outfit for my company. And this is the first sample that I've got. But anyways, I'm gonna take a shower and then try this stuff on, and we'll see what it looks like with me trying it on. All right.
Is
get you the motherfucking website 360. Back. So one thing I think is, so this is a large. I think the shorts need to be, I need to have the shorts made a little longer, obviously. I mean, this is cool, but not everyone likes, you know what I'm saying? Not everyone likes to show the quads. They ain't got quads that look like mine with the curvature at the bottom. So probably gonna need these made a little bit longer. And then the shirt, I don't like how this part comes out. Like, come on now. What they think, my fucking lats are like Bruce Lee's. So I'm gonna probably have this part, like, you see it's kind of curved like that.
Yeah.
It needs to be straight now. So I'll probably have that, the dimensions changed on that. But other than that, I think it's pretty nice, pretty doable. What do you think?
I like the design.
Yeah, it's pretty nice. Yeah, I love the shorts.
Yeah, I like the design for sure.
I just wish it was kind of more going on the shirt, but...
You don't want too much going on for the shirt, though, because it'll draw too much. Like,
but the shorts are fucking badass.
Oh, yeah, no, for sure, for sure.
And, I mean, I came up with this design on my own. You know what I'm saying? So, I'm having my website built right now as we speak, so I can get everything, you know, all my t-shirts and all my stuff, my clothes put on there. Like, I'm trying to build a whole Powerful Fitness brand of clothing. Like, I'm really trying to take it to the first level. I'm trying to get it to the first level, but then I'll take it to the next level. Can't take it to the next. I guess the next level is the first level. So this is the first outfit I'm coming out with. I'm getting my website built right now. Shout out to Preston Holyfield. He's a purple belt that I trained with at Carpe Momentum Jiu-Jitsu. He's badass. He'd be smashing me, pissing me off. Hey, if you can piss me off while we're training, you're fucking me up really good. You're doing a good job. So, but yeah, Preston actually has his own company. It's called, I believe it's called Rain. But he builds websites. And so, you know, once my website's finished, you'll get to see, like, what type of work he does, you know, what he's capable of. But, you know, he builds websites. And so he's building my website right now. And I'm going to be plugging in all my clothes as I get, as I get them rolling out. And so right now, I still have the Rainmaker. Right now, all I have is the Rainmaker tee. And... I mean, I bought 60 of them. You know, these are limited edition. Once these are gone, I'm just going to move on to the next. Only way I'm going to bring these back is if they're, like, high demand. Like, people really want them. But as of right now, I only bought 60. I've already sold some, so I have less than 60 of the Rainmaker tees. Man, they're direct-to-garment printed. They're signed. So, I mean, dude, get them while they last. And they're $50 a piece. Now, if you hear $50 and you think that that's expensive, well, don't worry. You're broke. It's not for you. You know what I'm saying? Go buy some cheap stuff. You know, some people can't afford a $50 t-shirt because they put their money elsewhere, drugs and stuff. So, you know, if you're on drugs and you don't have money for my t-shirts.
Way off topic.
They're like, I don't do drugs. I'm going to buy one. I got to prove this motherfucker I don't do drugs. But no, seriously, so the Rainmaker tees, they're $50. If you want to get one, just direct message me on Facebook or Instagram, and then you'll have to PayPal me, and I'll ship it directly to you. So, yeah, until I get everything put on my website, you know, you got to message me directly. But, man, once I get that website built, then y'all ain't got to fool me. Y'all ain't got to message me. Like, I don't want to talk to this fucking... I don't want to talk to this dipshit. I just like laughing at his videos, and I'm going to buy some of his shirts, you know. So, yeah, this is going to be the first outfit coming out. Like I said, I still got to get make sure my manufacturer gets the measurements right. So, but once they do that, I'm going to order probably 60 to 100 of these. So, be looking forward to that, all right? So, right now, it's... time for me to eat my lunch. I'll probably sit on the couch, put my compression sleeves on my legs, get my legs a little bit of recovery, yeah, I'm gonna get my lunch and then, you know, we'll see what's next. Rolling. All right, got the re-athlete on. Just some leg recovery, so it's got like compression and heat, and you know, it's just something to, good thing to do while I'm like eating lunch. So I'm getting some recovery, refueling at the same time. I got me a wrap right here with some dressing, and then of course I'm gonna wash it all down with some Prime, man. When you prime, well, you gotta drink Prime, man. That's this shit right here. That's that 5-5. Then after I'm done with this, I'll probably have to go pick up my kids soon from school and then just chillax until it's time to go to jiu-jitsu tonight. Right. 6:30, pulling up to jiu-jitsu. No gi tonight, time to get it in.
What the hell? You got a magnet on that?
Yeah.
Like those springboard floors?
Working out or what?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it's a lot more forgiving when you get thrown.
Yeah. Are you sore?
I've been feeling it.
So grab your partner and I'll set the timer. I'll just go maybe 4 minutes back and forth. The person that's getting taken down, give them both of those reactions. So on one of them, start to come up. If that's the case, take the back. Sometimes when they take you down, just stay flat on your back and look at them and say, no, I'm not gonna come up. Then you come up and take the arm bar. The entire time, don't let go of the more grip, okay? One, two, three. There.
Yeah.
Good there. That works.
Right, you're in the arm.
Kind of left leg over the head.
Remember, we're going back and forth, guys, back and forth. So one person and then the other person. We go under the head. Now, this elbow, even if it's tied up against the body, which is shifty, what I'm gonna do is I wanna go through and I wanna hook under. Keep it down for me, give me some juicing resistance. So here, we're gonna go underneath. And I'm gonna climb this up. Guys, make sure give me a lot of resistance. If I just try to pull this straight up, it's gonna be like this.
The pressure is supposed to be like you said, like a shoulder flex, right? That's what it is. Yeah.
That is so good.
Tap?
Yeah.
Yeah, got tight as soon as the other one came out and just had to.
Yeah, make that.
So this will be the last thing that we'll do. If you want, just start from that S-mount position and kind of play. Take the near side arm bar, but if they're defending, take the far side arm bar, shoulder lock, wrap around, and just take what they're giving you, okay? Last technique, 1, 2, 3.
Damn rope got me. Son of a bitch.
Well, my favorite part about it is getting better. Yep, getting better, that's my favorite part. Just, but I love everything about it. Yeah, man, just how you can do so much in every single position. You think there's one submission there, but there's literally 100. Like, it's just so many variations, and that's really the difference between, you know, like a lower belt, blue belt, purple belt, and like a black belt, and then even higher level black belts. There's just like so many freaking little changes you can make in every position. It's just nuts.
Actually, no, because I use, nope, usually don't.
Yeah.
Jared.
Four. Oh, that hurt my legs.
They're just talking, man. They're not bad about it like this. Yeah.
perspective there. I just was able to reach out to the S and I got hold of it. So I was like that.
Yeah, I'm good.
So here, this is good, man. You had a mountain triangle, right?
His hand was stuck in there, though.
His hand was stuck.
Oh, it was?
Yeah.
Here, so this one was over?
Had no, I had both.
Had this?
I had it. No, it was no. Here.
Yeah.
I had it wrapped in here,
this
but
one,
this
I wanted to get down. Elbow down.
Oh, I see.
It was like
I
that.
See. Okay.
It was like right.
So from right here, this was good. You actually rolled back, and you took this triangle this way, right? Okay. So remember, go ahead and come to your knees, defend. When he wraps this arm around here, this way.
Great class. Got a few rolls in. So now it's time to go home and take my ice bath, shower up, and eat dinner, and get my kids in bed. So you see it. It's an all-day thing, you know, every day, training my ass off. So no matter what, when it comes to competition, when it comes to my fights, win, lose, or draw, I come out of it humble and I come out of it just on to the next. You know, it's just, this is the lifestyle every single day. So Steven asked me, like, aside from, you know, fighting, making me feel like a straight beast, what are three things that, what'd you say? So what fighting really does for me, what martial arts does for me, is it gives me purpose. You know, everyone is always wondering, what's the purpose of life? And a lot of people find, you know, in religion, that's their purpose, you know, to serve God. But, you know, martial arts, it really, it gives me a reason to live. It gives me drive, like something to work on every single day. You know, humans are very, very problem-solving, prone creatures. Like, we want to solve problems and figure things out, and we want to figure out what's the purpose of life. So, you know, martial arts has really given my life purpose. That's what my life is about, you know, martial arts. So it really gives me purpose. And, you know, it makes me be a better me, you know, through discipline, through diet, exercise, my emotions, like everything. It just makes me be a better person, to be a better fighter. So, I mean, yeah. All right, time to clean the mats. All right. Just made it home from jiu-jitsu. As you can see, man, I'm a straight beast. So, man, there you have it. This is what my days consist of. Train in the morning, train in the evening, come home, take my ice bath, eat my dinner, go to sleep, wake up, same shit, all the way till fight night. So, you know, let's thank God for another day on this earth to just do, you know what I'm saying, what it is we want to do. For me, that's martial arts. For you, it's, you know, whatever you do. Shout out to Powerful Fitness, my one and only sponsor, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to the Powerful Fitness podcast. Tune into that as well. All right, let's check it out. See what we got today. At a nice cool 40 degrees. I don't know if you can see it. Okay. 40 degrees Fahrenheit. For you people that's not in the US, that's 1 degree Celsius. Okay. Always double check and make sure it's unplugged. I don't need to fucking get electrocuted in my own ice bath. Be looking like a dipshit.
That's all you need to do. There's no discussion.
You got the mic on?
So,
always gotta double check that too. Play this fuck up. Tell me you don't. Play this fuck up.
Straight in. Easy way to do it.
Yeah. It's good shit. So yeah, like I said, my fight is in 17 days, October the 29th, Memphis, Tennessee. I can't remember the venue, but you know, I'll put that on the screen. But you know, like I said earlier, guys, give the video a like, please subscribe to my channel, share it on your other social media platforms. You know what I'm saying? Give your boy some love. Drop a comment. Drop a shit emoji for all I care. Just drop some. I need some engagement. Let me know what you guys think. You know what I'm saying? If you ever have suggestions on anything. Not just fighting in life. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm a student. All hours of the day. Constantly learning. Constantly growing. Getting better. So, you know, if you have any type of recommendations, any type of suggestions, advice, drop it in the comments. Holler at your boy, you know. But as you can see, man, this is my life, you know. Every day, twice a day, recovery in between, after, and you know, staying on top of my diet, trying to eat very clean, staying in range. I think this morning I woke up like 155 pounds, and as y'all know, I fight at 145, so I'm hovering right where I need to be. I could actually be heavier if I wanted to, if I really cut weight, but, you know, I don't really cut. You know, I diet down as low as I can, and I cut a few pounds, 5 to 7, you know, no, nothing too major. But, you know, eventually it's going to be time for me to start looking into really how to diet down and water load correctly, because I don't do water loading, but I know that's what a lot of fighters do. So, you know, I'm just figuring it all out myself. I don't have no professional showing me how to cut weight. I'm just trying to figure this shit out as an amateur, you know, and making sure I don't get too big and eat like a, you know, like a tubby boy in between fights, just staying lean. But yeah, so ice baths, a lot of benefits to it. If you've never done it, you should look into it. So my cousin that's recording, Steven, was saying, he said he thinks he could do it, probably do 4 minutes or so, because he does cold showers. And I told him, I said, a cold shower is like, a cold shower is like comparing a swing set to a roller coaster. Like, this is cold. And this ain't fill your ice, this ain't fill up your bathtub with water and dump 5-10 bags of ice in. This is 40 fucking degrees from top to bottom. Like, this is a true cold plunge right here. This ain't no little, you know what I'm saying, ice on the top, warm at the bottom shit. This shit is cold. But, you know, one of these days, you'll come and try it out, and we'll definitely record that and get it on film and see how he does. You know, it's always a surprise. I never know when people get in there their first time if they're going to hop right out, if they're going to stay for a minute, or if they're going to stay for five. I've had people stay in for 4 or 5 minutes the first time. I've had people do 3 minutes. I've had people literally try to get in and they can't get in. They start screaming when it gets to their knees, to their waist, and they can't get all the way in. My MMA instructor, who thinks he's so tough, so, which I got that on film too. But yeah, so super excited for my next fight. You know, it's gonna be a blast. And just grinding, getting better every day. You know, BJJ blue belt. Finally got my blue belt after like 5 years of training, because I was, you know, training under people that don't really award belts. But after being at Carpe Momentum for, you know, a couple years, I finally got my blue belt. So, you know, major accomplishment, major achievement for me. And, you know, just grinding right now, trying to attend as many classes as I can and get better, and eventually earn the next stripes and the next belt, and just keep on ranking up, keep on getting better. So, but yeah, follow me on social media, subscribe to my YouTube channel, subscribe, hit the notification bell, hit the damn like button, hit all the buttons, and don't hit the dislike button, don't do that, come on guys, don't do that, all right, but anyways, that's 5 minutes, as you can see, no big deal to me, you know, nothing to a G. I do this every day, so, you know, it's just another day. But with that being said, that's my day, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Hit the like button, and looking forward to my next fight. Deuces. Easy work, baby, easy work.